me! Give me the jar!
The story opens with a brief first-person account of the funeral of Emily Gerson, an elderly Southern woman whose funeral is the obligation of their small town. Emily is a member of a family of the antebellum Southern aristocracy. After the Civil War, the family falls into hard times. She and her father, the last two of the clan, continue to live as if in the past. Emily's father refuses for her to marry.
It's been a while.
Yeah.
Mr. Grayson! Mr. Grayson!
Toby, open the door! Is Emily there?
Mr. Grayson!
Toby, who's that? Emily, stay right there! What do you want?
Good morning, Mr. Grayson. I just want to invite your daughter for the upcoming social event this Saturday.
No way! I don't let my daughter to attend such event like this, especially with a stranger! You're not allowed to go with another man, understand?
But father, you cannot passively keep me by your side forever!
Go to your room!
But father!
Now! And I don't want any of your moves! I had enough trouble, and I don't need any from you.
His death, the only person seen moving about Emily's home is Toby, a black man serving as Emily's butler, going in and out with a market basket.
Good morning, Miss Emily. I'm sorry, but we need to take the body.
Perhaps you could stop by your house and offer her condolences.
You heard the news, Emily. We're really sorry about your father's death.
What are you talking about? My father's not dead.
Poor Emily, all alone and lost, left with nothing more but sadness and despair. Emily is sitting in front of the mirror with a razor in her hand. When she's about to cut some strand of her hair, an explosion outside breaks the silence in her room. The explosion is so strong that it shakes almost all the stuffs inside her room. She gets stuck and frantically goes outside to know what happened.
Thank you.
With the acceptance of her father's death, Emily somewhat revives, even changing the style of her hair, and becomes friendly with the Homer Baron. Homer Baron is a northern neighbor who comes to town shortly after Mr. Wilson's death. Homer is inside in Mr. Grierson's house. Emily scotches him staring to the picture of his father.
Oh, that's my father. He passed away just recently.
Oh, I'm sorry. So, shall we?
Let's go.
As the relationship blossomed, this went on for many consecutive days. Homer Baron and Miss Emily Grierson, in a rather conspicuous manner, would leave every morning and come back late in the evening. They quickly become the center of gossip in Jefferson. The connection surprises some of the community, while others are glad she is taking an interest. However, Homer likes men and claims that he is not a marrying man. This draws attention to Homer's questionable sexuality in the story.
So, how's it been so far, bro?
Come on, man. It's just a date. Why so serious?
Oh, come on, man. Seriously?
You know, man, I'm not a marrying man, bro.
Cheers for that.
Have you heard about Emily?
What is it this time?
I heard she bought an electric toilet set.
So?
With Homer's initials.
Such a bad example. She's madness.
Let's call some of her cousins in Alabama to get some help.
Excuse me, miss.
Oh, good morning, Miss Emily.
I want some poison.
Can you tell me what kind of poison?
I want the best you have.
Arsenic?
Yes, I want arsenic.
But the law requires me to ask why you needed it.
I'm going to use it to kill some rats.
Miss?
To see you both here, my cousins.
It's nice to see you, Emily.
We are here for a reason. Why? Everything is just fine here.
It's not fine because we got a news that you had a relationship with the Yankee.
It's none of your business.
No, we care because you are a Grierson. You should not taint our reputation. Wake up, Emily.
Are you enjoying the night?
Of course. This is so horrible. Can I dance?
Yes, of course.
disgusting.
I thought Sophie must not have cleaning their house. It's getting worse and worse. I think you're right.
What can I do for you, ladies?
There is this terrible smell coming from Garrison's house. It's so awful.
The stench is so strong that they can smell from the houses. We said there weren't to be there.
Well, how can you accuse the lady of cleaning their house? But anyways, I was at a couple of my men to resolve this.
The council decide to send men to her house under the cover of darkness to sprinkle lime around the house. After which the smell dissipates.
When Miss Emily Gerson passed away, many Kreestown people come to attend her funeral, not because they are close to her, but to pay respect. Respect to a fallen monument and witness what's remained at once proud and mighty Gerson. She lied cold and distant style, far from the whole town's paying eyes. She always held up high, but all she got was pity and light. After she's buried, a group of townsfolk enters the house to see what remains of the grave out there. To leave the person's house and never see again, giving access to the person's house.
Good morning, Doctor.
Good morning. So, what was that?
There's a room upstairs that is black.
Is it locked?
It's locked.
Wait, wait.
Beside him is the indentation of a head in a single strand of gray hair, indicating that Emily has left with Homer's corpse. The house is an indicator revealing how Emily struggled to keep everything the same in a frozen time period, avoiding change.